How Do You Want It was unique on many levels. Something that became very apparent in the production company that I had with Tupac and Tracy was that the films that he wanted to make were films that normalized stereotypes about African Americans or blacks, or even allowed them expression, sexuality, emotions. These were things that he wanted to focus on, and he wanted to bring them out of the exploitation and put them more in the mainstream. So his ideas were always, if white people can have films like these, why can't African Americans have their erotic or sensual films like 9 1/2 Weeks? So the idea behind this video, he wanted to put the sexuality full throttle. I mean, the video was there, the lyrics matched it. So Pac was very particular. He made us hire Ron Hightower, who was a porn director. And Ron brought all of his talent, some strippers, all sorts of ladies of the night that were a part of this video. How Do You Want It was actually the first music video of a big series of music videos Tupac wanted us to create. It was actually the first one. This was followed up by two of America's Most Wanted, Made Niggas, and then the rest of them, All About You. So hit him up. So with this one, it was interesting because we had all the strippers and porn stars on set, and one thing that Tupac wanted to make sure was that all the girls were comfortable, and any male crew person that was on set, he made them take their tops off, because he was like, look, if these girls are going to be naked around us all day, you guys need to show a little bit of respect and get a little uncomfortable yourself. So Pac was always cool like that. He was very out of the box and sort of wanted to make sure that everyone felt comfortable, even though they were porn stars and strippers. He treated them all so nicely. There wasn't any sort of rudeness or disrespectfulness just because of, you know, what they did for a profession. So that was cool about it. I actually, unfortunately, didn't get to stay for the whole shoot because I was prepping two of America's Most Wanted. So I helped produce as much as I possibly could, but the location scouting and the crews and the gear and art department and talent and all that jazz. But a few hours into the shoot, I had to bounce and go prep two of America's Most Wanted, which was shooting the following weekend. Funny story about the end of the day in this video. Pac had invited Ron Hightower and all the girls from the video to his hotel suite, and Tracy and I had shown up. He had invited us there as well. So, you know, when we first got there, I mean, it was a little strange environment to be in a room filled with porn stars and strippers, but I wasn't complaining. In any event, Pac was playing some of his new tracks. Tracy and I were smoking a little bit of the sticky icky, drinking a little bit of that Alizé, and we started dancing in a corner. And then, you know, we were in our high in our own mind, and then the next thing you know, we turned around. All the girls were naked. Pac was naked on one side. Ron Hightower was naked on the other side. And they just had a chain of women in between them, all grinding up on each other. And it was about to go down. Tracy grabbed my hand, pulled me out of the room and said, we're out. Look, I don't know if I would have been a participant, but I definitely would have been a voyeur. In any event, unfortunately, that was as far as I got to be. That was as far as I got to be involved in that situation. But again, Pac was respectful, creative. He wanted to make sure everyone was comfortable. And as long as the train was a smooth train, he was cool. So that's my little story on How Do You Want It. Next up, hit him up.